Gummy. What's going on, man? Charlie the Block, check it out. Look, whatever I'm in my box today, there's gonna be a message. The other day, I was in front of my house, and a guy walked by. When that guy walked by, he asked me, excuse me, you happen to know what day it is? And I said, well, today's the 16th. He goes, well, you happen to know what day it is? I said, well, that's tomorrow, the 17th. Because I've been looking for a 40th Cobra for the last few days, and I just can't find one. So I said, well, what makes you want to look for a 40th Cobra for? And he said, because they bring good luck. And a light bulb got turned on in my head, and I just tripped out because I asked him this question. I'm going to ask you, America, do you believe in fate? When two people, two strangers are going to meet at the exact same point in time, at the same place, and this one person had a message for this one person. Oh, you woke up one morning, you had some numbers sitting in your head all day, and you kept thinking, go play the lottery. And you went and played it that night, and you won $35 million. Or you went somewhere with a group of friends to a certain place that you've never been, and you met the woman you love. You got married and had kids. So I told that guy, do you believe in fate? Because you found your four-leaf clover. There it is right there. You found your luck. So I had a message that came from my heart that he needed to hear at that point in his life. I found a lot more things after I told him what I had to tell him to find out he really did need that message. And that's when I realized, America, that I am the messenger. I was sent here by God to relay the message, to understand the severity of the problems that we as Americans are facing today. Because we as Americans signed a silent contract. Because we allow the stuff to happen that was happening now in our country today. To get us to where we're at today in our country's history, we allowed it to happen. The financial collapse of America is on your watch, you can believe it or not. And this is a little bit how it went. See, our government needed a lot of money, so they borrowed it.
Hey, can anybody got any money I can borrow? Well, how much do you need, America? Whatever you could give me. Well, here you go, here's $1 trillion, just borrow all this money. So now they got all this money, right? What are we gonna do with it?
They come over here and they say, well, let's get into this war over here. Let's give Pakistan $1 billion. You know what? They had an earthquake over in Haiti. Let's give them a freaking grip of money. Let's get into Vietnam. Let's get off the gold standard. Let's do all this stuff to just overwhelm the system financially. But hold on, we need more money.
Hey, can I get some more money? Sure, here it is. Go, see you later.
Now they got all this money and they just keep coming over and they keep spending. Go, 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 go. Welfare, SSI, disability, veterans pay, WIC, and all these other freaking socialist programs. Just go get it all out. But we need more money.
Can I borrow some more money?
Can't let you borrow no more money, dude. You guys don't know how to spend money. You guys are just effing up everything, and it's hurting countries all around the world because we all had your money stockpiled, and you're making it renderless. You're having it useless. So now we're broke. We don't got no money. So what did our government do? Start the presses.
Bring up that money, hurry up, come on, we have to get it out here, hurry, come on, come over here, keep shoveling it out. Come over here, keep shoveling it out.
But you can't do that forever. So now our country is financially collapsing because they didn't want to let us borrow it no more and they can't keep printing it or putting in a few decimals. So all that game is coming to an end on your watch, America. But we as Americans allowed it to happen because we signed that silent contract. We took government jobs and union jobs because you know what? They paid double what the private sector paid their workers. They got a 401k, a retirement, and freaking benefits that were just truly outlandish. But as long as you believed what they were promising you, that you were never gonna be paid out in the end, but as long as you believed them, you allowed it to happen. So all you people that have your 401k, your retirement, social security, disability, veterans pay, and all that money saved in the banks that you keep getting that statement or that check every month that you depend on the government for it, I'm sorry to tell you, it's all been swindled and it's been gone and they lied to you. Even though you have the statement, it's not there. That's why you can't pull that money out on your 401k. It's gonna be time for you to retire, and it ain't gonna be able to retire. You're gonna continuously need to work until you freaking die. Because they bankrupted the country. They infected freaking communism, socialism, Marxism in our country. All those entitlements, they took away your Constitution, Declaration of Independence. They just freaking ripped you off right when you were awake and asleep. They did it for generations. From when they gave the private sector banks, the globalist banks, the right to print our money. With every bill that they pass that restricts your freedoms and diminish the Constitution, they're doing it piece by piece, little by little. And it's our fault, because you signed that silent contract. I'm just a messenger, America. This is just things that need to be said. Because you know what? As long as we let them print it up, and as long as we kept borrowing it and they kept spending it, and there was no accountability, we got us to where we're at today, and it's our own fault. But there's a lot of people that are upset now about the establishment, the way they were doing it, and how they've been handling business, our government, throughout the world and domestically. So there's a lot of people with these different social movements that say they're going to get back at the establishment. And that has nothing to do with your freedom. Socialism is more government control. Look what the government did today. So you want to give them more control? Communism is more government control. You want to give them more control? Look at the DMV. It took too long for you to go through the line. So what does your government do? They take the clocks out. They didn't fix the bomb. They just took the clocks out. Okay. Marxism. That's more government control. You think they're going to give you more freedom and get out of the corruption? No. That's just getting us on a faster track to the same problems that we have today. The people that are paying your Republicans and your Democrats and all those social movements are the exact same people, the New World Order. They all have the same agenda and the same outcome. The only way we as Americans fight back against all this corruption and the establishment is through your Constitution and Declaration of Independence. I know a little bit more than the average person about politics, and I try to tell people on videos and in life, and people always say, oh, you don't know what you're talking about, you're dumb. I said, well, let me ask you a question. What if I were to tell you that George Bush and Obama are the exact same thing, but freaking Obama's 10 times worse than George Bush? And they go, no, no. I go, well, the same people that are paying both of them, they both have the agenda to spin our country into debt and to collapse the system. To me, they look like they're doing the same damn thing. No, no. What if I would tell you that every time they keep playing Republicans and Democrats left and right against each other, it's just a way to keep you freaking distracted from the problems that are going on behind the scenes. Because those Republicans and Democrats, they're on the exact same team. And people are like, no, no, no. I go, but let me ask you, can you just admit that I know more about politics than you do? And then those people will say, yeah, yeah, you do. I go, okay then, why aren't you listening to me? I'm just relaying the message that you need to hear at this point in time in your life, in our country's life, in our history of our country. I'm relaying the messages that you need to hear, America, that your common person in the country doesn't understand, or they refuse to put the pieces together. What the mainstream media isn't telling you. Because I can regurgitate all the exact same numbers. I can put on a tie, comb my hair really proper, say really good stuff. But that's not what you need to hear. You need to hear the truth. And that's what I came to tell you. See, I'm just a messenger. Because see, I need your help. Why do you think I don't put that many tags on my videos? Because I'm a two-finger typist. I'm just an average person just like you. I go to work 40 hours a work week, weekends off. I coach soccer. I got my wife. I got my kids. And I got my life. But I know the severity of the problems that we share as Americans. And the only way to fix it is if all of us are educated and understand the problems that we face as Americans together. Not left and right. That's in the past. We all need to come together and fix these problems. So, you want to help me? Come up with a generic list of tags that I can put on my videos. Share them with the next person. Because if you like what I say, any one of the videos, why hasn't one of my videos ever hit a freaking 1,000? 1,000 views. I don't even get 1,000 views. I get an average of 100. I'm just a messenger, people. See, our country's in trouble. Your life is in trouble. Your children need some help. Our country needs help. But as long as we as people sit in the sidelines and do nothing about it, they're gonna win. They're gonna collapse the country and take away your Constitution, your Declaration of Independence. This was an experiment. A man's freedom, if it could last. Look at any other country throughout history. It's always been the same thing. We as average people in the world all want the same thing for our families. To a good job, better for our kids, and to be left alone. That's what we as all people throughout the world share, whatever country it is. But it's always our governments that do all this tyranny to the people and to other countries to implement war, famine. It's not the people in the world, it's the government. And even your government, America, look what they've done to your country and look what they've done to the problems throughout the world. We as people need to fix the problems in our own lives, in our communities, in our cities, our states, and in our capital. That's the way we get back at all this corruption and lawlessness in our lives. So I tell you guys every time, if you're not going to do everything in your power to restore this country, you're going to do everything in your power to destroy it. Sorry about that one.